following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Hello and welcome to My Studio, a program that explores the artistic soul by sharing the creative process, vision, determination, and personal desire to create art. I'm your host, Ginny Barrett. In this episode, we visit the studio of Carla Sullivan. Creative imagination to repurpose old tools, carpenter boxes, and window panes into whimsical creations appeals to a wide audience. We joined Carla as she welded a small sculpture for a client. I will tell you this firsthand. The techniques demonstrated in this video are dangerous and should only be undertaken by trained individuals.
Hi, I'm Carla Sullivan and welcome to my studio. Thanks for letting us visit with you today, Carla. We saw you first at Greeley Park. And we saw your finished pieces of welded animals and characters and your lettered signs that were very interesting, and we hadn't seen anything like that before. So you were kind enough to invite us into your studio, and this is your space. You have a collection of tools. You were talking about that at Greeley Park when we were talking about collecting, and that you have
my hoarding
tools, your hoarding, yeah. your nuts and bolts, your tools that you work with, and then your materials. You're just surrounded with a whole collection of things. What do you like to work on most?
Usually I just like take a junk pile and throw it down and just see what comes to mind. Sometimes, so
very creative.
Yeah, I have my thinking stool. I sit down here and design, like, all my little buckets are actually, there's an organization thing to all of this. Certain letters and my round things are certain places for my clocks and motorcycle guys and plane saws. Everything's got its place. Nuts and bolts for the little eyes.
So you've been collecting this material for a long time. You've been doing this for how long?
Going on about 4 years.
4 years now.
Well, I've been repurposing for over 20, but I started to do stained glass, and it started getting me sick. So I always wanted to try bigger metal, and so I just went to school and started playing with the machine. My husband bought me a machine, and the welder, and just sitting here and just practice after 4 years. I'm finally getting to the point where I can know what tools to use and where to go find my things and pieces. And I have a lot of customs, getting to the point where I'm getting a lot of custom orders. And
excellent. You learned welding at Alburn?
Yes, at night classes.
Night classes. Yeah. Yeah. The only gal in the class.
I was, and I was trying to make wine racks where everybody's trying to learn how to fix car parts and things like that. Yeah.
Carla, you mentioned that repurposing, that you do that. Could you tell us more about that?
Well, I have a real problem for boxes, old boxes. So, and usually you find them in the garages, people's attics, everywhere. So I do a lot of those. I take them, I put legs on them, put insulation, put a tin in them and make them into coolers and with faucets and strings. And I like to work with anything that looks like it's got potential. Like, I have lots of stuff in here. I have an old Victorian radio over in the corner, and that's going to be a bar someday. Oh. I have like an old sled up there. That's going to be like a bar.
A toboggan.
Like a shelf bar. I just like to repurpose. A lot of these rusty tools just sit and, you know, it's a shame. They just sit in sheds and basements.
That's true.
So what I do is I grind them down and try to make something visually
so
nice
you're
out of them.
A tool rescuer.
I am. Yeah.
Very good. So when you find these tools, they're covered in rust.
They
are. They've been neglected and
waiting
left for
outside,
you to come
some
along.
In dumps.
In dumps?
Yeah, some, yeah.
So you go dump
metal,
picking,
I do.
Flea markets.
Yes,
what do you find
I have
barns.
My mom helps me a lot. She goes hunting for me, gives me beautiful piles of metal junk. Yes, and then I go to flea markets, dumps, metal piles. Anywhere I can. I've actually been doing this long enough that I actually have people starting to bring me stuff. I had this lady at one of the fairs brought me this big bag of old garden tools that was sitting out by in a yard. And, you know, I have some car people bringing me transmission parts. And, my name's, people are starting to bring me stuff, so it's nice.
All right, I brought you a couple of things today.
Yeah, so I just get to create.
What are people looking for when they buy you things? You need stainless steel.
Yeah, that would be fine.
Yeah. Or iron pieces.
Yeah, yep.
Brass.
Brass, no, you can't.
Not so much.
I can't weld to brass.
Okay.
Well, maybe somebody else can. I can't. There's certain things. It's mostly using my machine. My machine is a pretty good machine, so my welder. I collect all kinds of old garden hand tools, regular tools, rakes, outside garden tools, wheels, anything round, you know, and then the regular tools and bolt nuts and bolts, big nuts and bolts and anything that looks interesting.
What's your biggest call for? I think you mentioned C-clamps when we were at Grilly Park.
Yes, I use a lot of those for my letters because they make great C's, E's. I use those. I use a lot of nail pullers, a lot of wrenches. I love the little curved wrenches, like the ones that have character to them. And I have the S-shaped ones. Let's see if I can find one so I can show you. Like these, I love these. These make great hands and arms, and I have I'm starting to make a lot of stump art when you cut down a tree, like in your yard, and you don't want to get the stump removed. It just sits right on top of your stump, and they hold like little solar lights and for the nighttime in your garden or planters, and I use a lot of these for the arms.
Well, your thinking stool must work very well.
It does.
That's
yeah.
very creative
yeah.
to see something out of a wrench and envision it as another piece or a part. That's great. So we're going to try to do something today.
Yeah, I was going to teach you how to make a scrappy dog.
Okay, all right.
So we're gonna start with grinding, and definitely need to get some goggles on.
Safety equipment.
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
Because I have gotten pieces of rust and metal in my eye and had to have it removed. And then you're gonna need some gloves. I got you some nice new ones.
Now you need to wear the safety equipment, and you need to take the rust off.
Yes.
So that the weld will hold?
Yeah, you can't weld to rust. So you either have to grind it off or burn it off. So,
okay.
So we're going to start with grinding our scrappy dog pieces.
Wait, we have to see me in
So
this.
You don't need to put these down. That's for the welding part. Okay, you just need those glasses on.
Getting my gloves on.
Now this is going to get a little bit loud. Just keep your fingers away from here because it can chop. Just hold it like that.
Do not try this home.
No.
Leave this in the hands or the gloves of a trained professional.
I'll do these little ones. Try to give you something big so you can just keep your hand way away from that part.
Okay.
Like this part, okay?
Okay, yes ma'am.
put the fan on, get rid of the, all right, so we're just gonna grind all these down. You wanna push over here? Okay. Want me to start it?
Yeah.
And show you how? Okay. So we're just gonna... You can feel pieces like... This is the most important part because this is what I'm gonna be welding to. I gotta get all that rust off. Prefer not to do this, or do you want to
do it?
Okay. Okay. So. This is going to be a stain.
Yeah.
I'll just grind where we're gonna weld and I'll save the other parts for later. Also need to set the negative clamp on the piece, so you have to...
Okay, right.
Want to try again or no?
No? Are you good? I'll try one.
Okay. So just, yeah. Yeah, just do the bottom first. What we'll do is we'll weld them together, make them, and then we can grind them. It will be easier to grind them. And I'm going to take this for a minute. And I'm going to need this piece all grinded because that's where I'm going to be welding.
Okay.
I'll help you hold it.
Alright, I'm going to leave this in your
Okay. I got it.
That can really get away from you.
And what?
It can really get away from you.
Yeah, I've cut holes in my, right through my gloves in. But I have a big 10-inch disc on that cuts, like that will cut right through this stuff.
Wow.
So, these are my eyeballs. They're gonna be our eyes. Yeah. Like for smaller items.
And clamp.
Grind through the right wheel. Sometimes I leave rust on them because I think it gives them more character.
Yeah.
But I won't be able to weld them together if I don't take it off. Thank you.
So my sculptures, I usually don't worry about trying to get all the rest off it right away because it's almost easier once they're made.
Yeah.
My signs, though, I grind, like my love sign. I sell a lot of love signs. I usually like to grind them all down because they're hard to get inside the grooves. So I grind them down as much as possible. But when we're making a sculpture, I just need to grind off where I'm going to be welding.
Okay.
Now.
All right. So the pieces we use, this will be the dog's face.
Yeah. And then I was thinking I was going to make him sitting down, this guy. Because I just...
So those would be
It's pretty bad. I don't even know what like these are. I think it's something to do
with the fire.
Yeah. Some of my tools, I have really old tools and I don't know what they are, but I just see legs. This is looks like a leg to me. And so these are his back legs, I was thinking. So we're going to put his head up there. And this can be his little tail. So.
And these eyes will go on the face.
Yeah. Yeah. So we'll put those little eyes like that. And then we can decide if he wants whiskers or not. So.
Yeah, that's what I need.
So we're going to move over to the welder, the welding table.
All right.
Okay.
Let's go. Let's take our parts over there.
Okay.
Go
and
to here.
So this is our, you have to have grounded. I'm going to give you some gloves.
Okay.
Now, this is where the sparks fly. And as you can see, I don't have any kind of lawn mowers or anything else or gas tanks because there's been a lot of people that blew up their sheds and work areas and studios. So we're pretty safe in here. There's nothing really flammable. I have my little fire extinguisher over there. I think the hardest thing, the most important thing is learning your machine. And
this is a Hobart.
A Hobart, yeah.
140. What does the 140 mean, Carla? Is that like a voltage or?
Yeah, it's a 115 volt wire feed. It's a 140 amp. So,
is that something that most like farm?
This is a MIG welder.
MIG welder.
Yep, it's a MIG welder, and I do not use a tank. I use the flux core wire because I don't trust myself with a tank. I started with the tanks and I kept leaving the tanks on.
Oh
so
my.
I went through like three tanks in like three weeks because I just didn't shut them off. So
the tank is more for like arc welding and what you're doing is maybe rod
welding?
Well,
it's a cleaner weld. Like you're going to see I leave a lot of, it leaves a lot of like gray slime on it. Not slime, but that I have to grind off, but I grind them off anyway. So this way I feel like I don't have to worry about, it's just wire fed in here. So this wire, it's already got the flux in it.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so there's no tank with different gases I have to worry about. And the hardest thing is just learning where to set it on. Like if I'm doing something little, like I work with a lot of rusty tools, nails, the old rusty nails, I'll put it on a lower setting. Anything light, like this guy, like this guy that you brought me, he's really light metal. So I won't set the volts up too high. You know what I mean? Anything heavy, I have to set it up higher.
So like these are
this
a thicker material.
Yeah, that's sort of like a medium material. I have like car parts, a lot of heavier stuff, or like outside tools, the shovels, rakes and things like that.
Oh.
I would put on a higher thing. So what we're gonna do is make sure you got your goggles on. And
yes, ma'am. Safety first. Oh my goodness, it's so black in there.
I just wanna make sure I gotta plug it in. That would be good. I always leave this unplugged because I just feel it's dangerous.
So where would you start first? You're going to start with joining the
legs
together?
Yeah.
And then you have a base to work on?
Yeah.
And how do you know how to balance it? How did you know?
You know what, it's just, it's all a balancing act.
I guess,
so.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure I got a spark. So put your.
Oh.
Okay.
Does that,
I could
sure
still
that
see it. Yep, no, okay. I could just see a green thing.
So what I'm gonna do is,
I have to make this like
can't
sturdy.
Even see you.
So what I'm gonna do is just weld this part right here for now so it will give me sturdier legs.
You got those down?
Down.
Nope. We didn't grind. Didn't grind it down enough.
Wow. See, now we didn't grind that down right there enough. And it, did you see how it was spitting the
yes.
sparks?
Yeah.
That's because we didn't grind it down enough. But this is a pretty good welder that it burnt it. As I was doing that, it burnt off that rust
yeah.
and eventually grinded it. So here's his little legs. And I'm going to...
How is that for the camera, Paul?
Are you... Yeah? You're okay? All right. So I was going to do this to this. Like that.
Okay.
Just going to get...
You don't clamp them, or?
No. Yeah, I've kind of, like.
Okay, yeah, I see. Your hand clamp.
I've gone through my gloves before, and probably should, yeah, but.
Down.
This is not clamped.
Oh, unless we didn't grind it. It should be all right on the metal table.
Okay.
So we'll try it. Nope. So.
Remember I told you we had to grind off a space for.
Yes.
Okay. So this, actually, that's not thick enough. Let's just put this down for a second.
Do we need to re-grind that?
I grinded two sides right here on this guy. So that I wouldn't have.
Now are you ground, is that the ground wire?
Yes, yeah. This is sending the volts through the metal. I don't feel like it. You know what, I'm gonna go grind this a little more.
Okay.
Okay? I'll be right back. Just put these on. I feel like this piece is a little thicker. Be better to... That way we don't have spit back. I should have done the bottoms. Sorry. Got two more. This way I can put the clamp on the table. That one's not. I got to take that one off. All right, we should
so
have
that
enough.
Was, you were grinding the bottom.
Yeah, because
so that it
as
makes
long
contact
as,
with the table.
Right.
And you can ground the table now.
Right.
Instead
of that.
To
yep.
Ground
yep.
the piece.
Correct. Yeah. So I'm going to just, I just wanted to figure out what angle I wanted his feet at. So I'm going to, I think I want his feet like this. It's all a, just what, I guess what I prefer. So, kind of like them like that.
Maximus Prime.
I just want to get an idea of where I want to grind weld them. I think he's cute like
Very
that.
Very cute.
Yeah, I think he's cute like that. So, unless...
You can see why balance is so important.
Yeah, I'm just going to try this too. I kind of like them better the other way. So I'm going to put this down. Okay. Yeah, sometimes I forgot to put my helmet on because I have my goggles and like your daydream, you're
yeah,
in your
yeah,
sleep, you're singing sparks flying. And
okay, you all set?
Down.
You always want to weld both sides.
Okay. Is this a spot weld or tack weld? Is that what you would call
it? Yeah. Yeah, and if I don't like it, then I can just take it apart. I said I wanted to put them like that, yeah.
Down.
All set?
Yes.
All set?
Down. What an amazing light show.
Yeah. Okay, so then I was thinking, I don't know if we want his head turned a little bit, or what do you think? Kind of like him turned a little bit.
Dogs usually turn their head, you know, to the side, like,
yes.
They, like, what?
Yeah, I think I like them like that. Okay, you good?
Down, yep.
Sorry. Okay, so now I'm gonna add his tail. Gotta figure out where I want to put his tail.
So how much has to be touching for you to feel that it's secure and you can do a good weld on it?
Well, see this space in here?
Yes.
You want to leave a little bit of a space so that this wire can fill that in.
Get in there and
yeah.
Fill it in.
Yep. And then you want to do both sides because otherwise it will just snap off. Like, I'll show you. Like this could just like pop off like that.
Oh my gosh.
I have to do underneath.
Okay,
after too. After, underneath and then on top. I probably shouldn't have done that.
Wow, right. That was a demonstration.
Yeah, because if I don't do underneath, it's just going to snap. And actually, yeah. After I'm done making things, I know this is crazy, but I throw them on the floor to make sure that they hold.
That's a test.
Because, yeah, it's a test for me because I've really only been doing it, you know, not that long. So, all right, I'm going to put his head back on.
Okay.
And then I'm going to do the bottom and
all around.
You're all set?
Yes.
I can't really see this. Okay. Stepping on my wire. So now I'm gonna, like this is, I could still break that off, so. Make sure I get the back and the side and. See, so when it does that, that means that this isn't, we didn't grind that down enough. So I'm not that good about how to do that. So in that case, we could do this. Put the ground right on.
Okay.
And then what? now. There's no way I could break that off.
Wow, it would pass the floor test.
Right, it might, yep. I'm just gonna do this side too, just to make sure.
Got them on there good?
Yes.
Yeah, there's no way that guy's going anywhere now. All right, so now I just put his tail on. Thinking like right here.
He looks like a happy dog.
I always try to make stuff that I like. In case I get stuck with it. So, all right, here goes his tail. I'm thinking I'm gonna put it on at a little angle. All right, ready?
Ready.
I'm just gonna tack it to make sure I like it right there first. What do you think? That looks like a good place for it. Yeah, and you got these.
Oh, that's so cute.
If you feel this, it's very hot. Like you can feel the heat right through your. Yeah, you got, I gave you.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Okay, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Okay, got them down?
Down.
Gotta make sure I get both sides, and because otherwise you'll be able to break it right off. Okay, so we just got like his little eyeballs to put on. Kind of like that side better, I think.
I have a question for you,
yeah.
Carla. The lens in your mask, it has to be lighter than what I have here.
It is. Soon I can see, if you want to try it, I can see through this, but soon as that welder goes on, it gets dark.
Oh, is that how it works? Okay.
Yeah. Like, as soon as the welder goes on, it gets dark.
Then it would get dark like these.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm like, how can she absolutely see?
Yeah, that, well, yeah.
Because with these on, well, it's total blackness.
Yeah,
total
I mean, I, if you want.
Until you start working. And then I can see what you're talking about.
All right, I'm going to grab my little pliers there, because I don't like to hold things that close. I'm gonna put my eyes together first. Oh, so there's our little scrappy dog. It's coming to life. That's cute.
The eyes just bring it to life.
Yeah, yep. I love little things like this. Like, I think these are transmission gears.
Yeah.
But, oop. Like right now, I don't have the capabilities of taking whole transmissions apart. So I have these guys that, mechanics and stuff, that have been bringing me pieces.
You have to have connections.
Yeah, you need your connections. All right, I'm gonna.
All right.
I wanna make sure you're all set.
Down.
Didn't grind it.
Okay. So usually it wouldn't be jumping around like that.
Yeah.
Because I grind them down more, but I mean I could keep you here all day and I don't want to do that, so. All right, so our eyes, I just gotta figure out where I wanna put them. Thinking like right there. That will give us a better ground.
Yeah, high is cute.
Right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, right there. Yeah, I gotta just make sure I got them even before I
put it on.
Crack it. Okay, you got yours down?
Down.
Nope. You know what? Nah. Sometimes those give me a hard time. Yeah, hold on.
Is that because it's not ground?
It's because it's not, yeah. Well, no, it's not grounded.
Need to grind it down again?
It's not ground. No, it's this. It's not grounded. Sometimes these give me a little bit of a hard time, and then my wire is too long. Yeah, this is a wire-fed welder, so. No, just clip right there.
And there you go.
Yeah. Yeah, you see me doing that on the table?
Yeah.
It's because my wire's too long.
Oh.
So, all right.
Down.
Okay, one scrappy dog. But I'm gonna do underneath.
Underneath,
his,
okay.
Yeah, just to make sure. Try it.
I can't see a thing until
if
I do
if you
that.
Want to do with this.
Oh my God. Can I try one?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah, take that
okay.
off. You'll see.
I'll transfer with you.
Okay. I want you to put it down just to make sure you got, I can unscrew it. You good?
I think so, yeah.
You're not
okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
That better?
Secure.
Just make sure you leave your gloves on.
You need these.
Yeah.
All right, so.
So, this is the button.
That's the.
You're all right, you're not touching.
That?
Like, look, you can press it now. Go ahead. So, okay,
oh.
That just feeds the wire.
Yeah,
it's all
yeah,
right,
it
you're not, you
wire.
Don't have a ground.
Okay.
So you're okay, but now I'm gonna cut your wire because it's too long. Yeah, you don't have to.
Okay,
it's
so
it's not dangerous
wire.
Until
okay.
you've got a.
Until I touch.
Grounded, yeah, yeah. All right, so we'll have you do like right there, see that hole?
Yes.
Right in there? You can fill that, so hold it like really, like close like that, okay?
Okay.
Now, and then just
pull the trigger.
But yeah, but I'm gonna, I don't even have the machine on yet, so just wait till I turn the machine on, all right?
Okay, all right.
Let me put my goggles on. Hold on.
This is a first.
Okay, Ginny is welding.
Ah!
All right.
Oh,
let
I can
see. Let me put the thing on. Okay.
Everything's grounded.
Yep, get close. If you're not close, lift up the. Nope, you're not hitting the metal. Okay, wait a minute. Let me cut you. Hold
cut
on.
Cut it again.
You know what I do? I go like this, get right in here, and then put your mouse down right at the last minute.
All right, can I hold this thing?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
All right.
You want to be right close. See how close you are?
I'm like, I can feel.
Yeah.
I'm touching it.
Yeah.
That's good.
That's perfect.
Okay. Don't try this at home.
No, I'm going to turn you on. You ready?
Go.
Okay. Here we go. Nope. Stop. They're not. Let me see. Yeah.
So I think I need a professional's touch here.
No, you must. Hold on. Let me just see this for a second. I just won't look at it. Nope, we're not grounded. That's why. That's not grounded. That's why. It's not your fault. See? That wasn't your fault. Which way? Yep. Yeah. See the spark?
Yeah. Yes, I did.
Okay. So that was. We just weren't grounded.
Cut it again.
All right. Let me get my goggles ready.
I can hold.
I'm gonna. See, if you get good, you can just click your head down and go like, go, yeah, go ahead. Yes. That's how professionals
with the
do
little
it.
Head.
All right, so hold this good right in there.
Yep.
Okay, you want to hold it at an angle, otherwise the wire is going to feed back into it and clog it.
Okay.
Okay, so you don't want to, like, right about there. Okay, I'm going to turn you. Whoa, you were touching. That's okay. You might be dreaming some sparks tonight. Okay, go ahead. Hold it steady. Okay, that's good. Perfect. Okay, you can stop. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh my God, that was fun!
So, yep, you just welded a scrappy dog.
Yes!
So, depending on... I gotta shut this off. And I'm gonna unplug it too, because I always, just to be on the safe side. Now this is very hot to touch.
Oh yeah, I bet.
So you still.
Can we just turn it so the camera can see all the weld in here?
Yeah, and see
especially
how the
my
slag.
Part right there.
Yep,
right there,
that's the slag. That's
slag.
What. Yeah, that is. Because of the flux wire I use,
okay.
A regular tanks would not leave you that.
Okay.
But I like to grind all these down anyway, so it doesn't matter. And then I'm not spending, I was buying tons of tanks because I kept leaving them on. So what we would do next is just grind them down a little bit.
You're gonna take all of these little bits and
take them down.
Pots
and
off.
Then I have, depending if I like them rusty or not, sometimes I like them rusty.
With your grinding tool, you can add texture to it too.
Well. So we're going to move over here. I'm not going to use that one because the disc is already. So I'm just going to grind down all his little parts that where we did. And then I have a spray that I put on that prevents any more rusting.
Should I put goggles on for this?
Yes. Yeah. They have glasses, but sometimes it goes on through the sides and stuff.
I'm kind of liking these.
Gets really in there, but I don't We're just going to go with this big one right now. And I think I want his tail shiny. So before he goes like into glorious possibilities on Main Street in Nashua, I have a booth upstairs on 257 Main Street. Before he goes there, I have a little grinder that gets right inside all the little crevices and stuff. But so he has our Scrappy Dog.
I think we should name him Sparky.
Sparky, okay. So, that's...
Carla, that was fabulous. Just the equipment you need, the education, what you've learned over the years,
your imagination. Yes, a lot of self-taught.
It's just really impressive with your work. Now, where do you keep your stock of your completed pieces at Glorious Possibilities?
Yeah, on Main Street in Nashua, 257 Main Street, Nashua. Upstairs, I have a booth. We do a lot of local shows, a lot of shows. But after I'm done this piece, I do have some stuff that I spray. If I don't want any more rust to come on, it's a neutralizer.
Yeah.
And then also, you could put like a clear polyurethane spray on it, and it'll keep his shine and stuff. So that's our little, I don't know. And I usually like just throw them down and make sure he stays together. See, and that wasn't strong enough, so I'd have to go back to the welder.
We pulled his head off earlier.
Yeah.
It didn't do him any good.
Yeah. I go back to the welder and I gotta fix him.
And then you fix him up. Wow, the doggy hospital.
Yeah, the doggy hospital. So, it will just take me 2 seconds to fix him. But yeah, that's my test. I do that because of all the shows and stuff and all the packing and...
How long does it take you to pack for a show?
The setting up and the stuff is really, really heavy too, so...
So all those boxes you repurposed, you put your stuff in some of those?
Yeah. I do a lot of... I don't like to do stained glass, but I do... I still like to make fork people.
I love the fork people.
Yeah, little people out of forks and anything that looks like interesting. And that's soldering, that's not welding.
Oh, okay. So. Now, is that with silver? You have to have absolute silver plate, or does it have to be solid?
Yeah, stainless, I would have to weld. Silver plate, I can solder.
You can solder.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right, because it's a lot more delicate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So should I
I'll wait on fixing him.
Oh, put his head back his on back. And okay. Feel bad for Sparky.
Okay. Yeah, that was kind of threw him down the wrong way here.
Ooh, I broke my glasses. Well, I'll just hold them.
See, so obviously, we didn't like his head that way. We wanted it turned.
Oh, he wanted it different.
I'm gonna close this up a little bit. See, it's a lot of trial and error. When you're, I probably should go to classes a lot more. All right, you got your goggles?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Sparky, your head's going back on. I think he's good.
Oh, he's on the solid now.
Yeah, he's good. Okay, so, sometimes I found that I don't clamp these guys good enough, so the leg like flies open. That's why I did the legs first. And so I guess that's it. One Scrappy Dog. Oh, the way we put him, kind of, I'll clean him up a little bit later.
Carla, when people want to see your finished work, mm-hmm. where would they go to see those delicate little fork people?
Probably the best thing to do would be to go on my website, New Beginnings by Carla with a C.com. And you can, on there, I keep updates of where I'm going to be showing.
Oh, great.
I do a lot of shows. Or when I have some stuff in the city room in Nashua, if you go for breakfast, you'll see my stuff on the walls. But in order to get a full idea of all the things I can do, because I like a challenge, like somebody asked me to make a Scrappy Dog.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm going to, what's going to happen is going to clean him up, take a picture, send it to the person. If they like it, they can buy it. If they don't like that one particular one, we'll try again and shove him in the store.
Oh, okay.
So, I would say the best thing to do is go on my website, csully, or email me at csully05@comcast.net.
Okay.
But it's newbeginningsbycarla.com, and you can see everything that I do there, all the repurposing, the trunks, the lights, the stump art, my fork people. And you'll be able to find my shows, where I am. I love the challenge, so if anybody has anything particular they want made, like I had to do a two-man saw for a wedding gift that said, love is working together with two little people on it.
Aww.
And that was a wedding gift. And I have a lot of custom things, names, signs with the old saws and, for barns and things like that.
And give, grandpa's tools.
Yeah, grandpa's workshop, and he's on a little saw. You'll see stuff like that on my website.
Oh, nice. Carla, thank you so much for
inviting. Well, that was fun.
And I never thought I'd have the opportunity to do welding.
Yeah.
And I will leave it in your capable hands. This is the end of my career as a welder. But thank you.
Oh,
thank you
welcome.
So much.
It was nice having you.
Great. Thanks a lot.
Special thank you to our guests, the artists, for allowing us into their creative space. And thank you for joining us in my studio. Please tune in again as we continue to visit the working studios of our talented neighbors.